Hey guys and gals, welcome back to Steven's Garage 216. And today we're at where I work, the shop where things get fixed and work done. This is the truck that I drive. It's a 2014 Freightliner. And as promised, what we're going to do is we're going to put some bumps into the Freightliner. We're going to get the stereo system upgraded just a little bit. What we've got here is a dual brand, name brand dual. It's a MP3 thumb drive. It's got Bluetooth, streaming music, so I can have my phone on it and run the Sirius XM or the iHeart Radio. Let's see, it's got voice activation on it. iPlug. I don't use iPhone. I actually only know like two people in this whole city of Cleveland that use iPhone. That's it. Everything that you possibly need, because you're, semi-truck, you should be concentrating more on the road than anything else. We've got here an installation kit for the amp. We've got a 1500 watt Soundstorm amp that we're going to put on to a 12 inch dual voice coil subwoofer that we will put. This is a sleeper, not a very big sleeper, but we're going to try and put this either right in front of the bed, the bunk, or we're going to put it down inside the bunk underneath, because your bunk actually lifts up, and you'll see that in this video. So what we're going to start with first is we're going to get this, we're going to figure out where we actually want this sitting, and then we're going to work on getting our 4-gauge power wire for the amp ran into the area or near the area of which we're going to keep the subwoofer. I would like to be able to mount the amp here because of the size. I don't know. We'll see what happens like that. But this is what we've got in store for you today. And we've got a really, really, really good bonus footage that I'm going to plant in the end because we're skipping all over. But I got an awesome bonus footage video for you guys to see today. It's going to make up for the whole last two with the black IROC. And that's it. Let's get to the video and let's get inside the Freightliner and take a look, see what's inside. Here's the under of a hood. Here's what it looks like inside here. Lots of stuff to memorize and know when you have a CDL. Let's go inside and take a look and figure out where we're going to put this 12-inch sub. There's the original radio CD player, but there's no Bluetooth or anything on it, and it has this cable here, which, honestly, while you're charging your phone and you're listening to something, it just makes an awful radio hissing noise through the radio, so that sucks. We don't want that no more. You can see I got my little dustpan and stuff on the floor there, and it looks like I need to take the garbage out. And here is the bunk. This is the bed area. I know it's got messy. I'm not really an over-the-road guy, but sometimes when I'm sitting for long periods of time getting loaded or unloaded, I will still lay here. But this is what I'm talking about. So we slide this over, and then we slide that over, and then the bed comes up. And I seriously think right down in there, if we bolt it down, oh, you guys probably aren't seeing that very well. So, we got the bunk up, and right down in there is where this sub will go. I think it'll be better down in there than out here in the middle of the floor. I'm pretty sure it's going to be loud enough for what we need. So let's set the subwoofer down in there. Let's pause this video. Well, I'll pause the video. It won't be a pause for you guys. I'm gonna get the subwoofer down in there and a little bit more light, and we'll be able to see what we're doing. And there it is. It's sitting down in there just right. Got a little extra light set up. Just like that. And the bed comes back down and locks into place. So we just slide this little, see that? You just slide that over, and the bed comes back up again. So there it is. So now we know where that's going. We know we're gonna put the amp right there. We'll mount it down because I don't wanna put it on the box there. But we'll put the amp right there, and then we're gonna drill a hole straight down because right underneath those stairs right there is where the battery, is where the batteries are at. And yes, I said batteries. Semi trucks have 2, 3, 4 batteries on them, you know. Could be 2, could be 3, could be 4. Okay, so we know where we want the sub. And I have these little, like, clamps that I'm going to use on each side of it. And then hold it down in the spot that we picked right here. That's just the air for the seat to go out. So, radio is for the dash. Here is our cable pack, or however you'd like to look at it, so that we can install the amp. We'll take a look and see what we've got in here for everything. Well, we've got our 4-gauge red wire for the batteries. We've got some wire loom to make things look all nice and professional. We've got our RCA cables, which will come in nicely. And blue wire, which is usually for the remote, the remote on the amp, so that when the radio gets turned on, this will supply a 12-volt supply to the amp and turn the relay on so that the amp will actually work. And this is a really nice kit. Looks like we got some zip ties in here. We've got rubber ends to cover up your loom pieces and stuff for the speakers. We've got a nice fusible link in here that will help out. We've got a black ground cable wire and this speaker wire that will work out great. All of this is going to work out. I think this is a really good kit. And I'm sorry that I kind of repeated that a couple times, but it happens. So we've got a really nice kit here. This is great. I'm really going to enjoy installing this. I love doing this kind of stuff, and I've never done it in my own semi-truck before. So the stereo doesn't sound too bad now, but again, it's when you're playing, and I don't have a spare phone to use, but I'm sure somebody out there has experienced this, that when you're running, you have your battery getting charged for the phone, and then you're using like a service like iHeart or Sirius or whatever you may be doing, when you have just an auxiliary 3.5 running into the phone and you're charging at the same time, you get this nasty weird hiss sound. So with a Bluetooth radio, we can avoid all that because everything will Bluetooth. We've got a microphone, by the way, that we'll put in up here for when you're talking. That's it. That's all I can think of right now at this moment. I'm ready to get to it and get recording, you know, get installing this amp and stuff like that, which I want to kind of open this up and show you. We'll take a good look at it real quick. What we've got here is a base knob that we'll install. We'll put here somewhere on the dash. Instructions. Who needs those? But here is our amp, and I like it. I like it because look at the size of it. It's a nice compact little amp, you know, 1500 watts. Like I said, probably more like 350. Because there's nowhere on here. It's not a solid 1500. There's no way. It doesn't even have, it just says that it's 2 ohm stable, but it doesn't mean that it's 1500 watts at 2 ohm stable. That's all that's on here. So we'll have to figure it out. I said who needs instructions, but I will look through here to see, because I mean, it's only a single sub, so a single sub, and there's only a positive and negative that's going to go to that single sub. But we also know that it's a dual voice coil, so we're going to find out what's going to work and operate best for us. Are we going to take the negative and positive and just go negative and positive to negative and positive on the amp to, or yeah, on the speakers? Are we just going to go from the amp negative and positive to the positive negative on the sub and then still keep it to positive negative? Or are we going to run it in series, parallel, Stay tuned. Let's get to getting this stuff installed and we'll figure it out as we go. Thanks. All right. So we're ready to install our red wire. And first, what we need to do is we need to drill a hole in the floor of the truck so that we can get it down to where the battery box is, where I was showing you underneath those stairs on the driver's side there. So we're going to drill a hole, get it down, and work it over to that. Make sure our 4-gauge wire fits down in there, because I just realized that I picked a bit and didn't see if it was the same as the wire. Oh, look at that, we're in luck. And the other cool thing is I noticed in this package, where is it? Oh, there it is. There is this cool thing here that you guys will like. This is really cool, so you're not like cutting into the sides of the wire when you drill a hole like that. You've got a rubber grommet here. So this will go in the hole, and it's got a slit, so it'll sit in the hole. And then your wire will go through that instead of rubbing and cutting through your 4-gauge power wire. And that worked out very well. Let's take a look at it. Let's take a look. And there is our hole. Let's see if we can get some light on that. There we go. There's our hole. And here is our red cable. Look at that. Look at that. What a nice fit. So we'll get that ran. Let's stretch this out. We'll push enough down there that I can reach underneath there and grab it. So we've got our side step off. We got the cable pulled down through. And I know it's a little dark, but you can obviously see this is red. This is the plus sign. A plus sign on the top of the battery. And this side here is your negative. You can also kind of see the red there. And this is all tied in. So this is the red. And then here's our cable. And you can see I've already spliced it back. And this is the type of adapter you'd want to use for your power cable. Okay. And that's what it looks like when it's installed. This is the kind of a piece that you want to use when you're putting a battery cable or adding, you know, what we're doing here for a stereo on a semi. But you would add this piece here and then put it onto your positive. You can see we got it running up. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna throw a few zip ties in on there. Keep this like so. I'll put a couple of zip ties on there and then zip tie that back. And then we'll get back on the inside of the truck. Okay, so we got that hooked up to the batteries. Yes, I'm gonna leave all the excess. We got our fusible link that will mount. But out of the fusible link, we splice back just a little bit of the wire. And we have this fitting on here that will go on to the positive. I have to pull this off because I can't see that. Let's see here. Oh. Battery. So this will go on this one. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the ground hooked up and we'll be right back. Okay, so here we go. I've got a little further than I said, but we've got the ground hooked up to the screw there, or the bolt down there. And another fitting just like how we put on the positive, but we put it on the negative. And we've got the remote wire hooked up. And then you can see here we've got positive on the left, negative on the right. We've got the darker wire, the gold wire on positive, and the silver wire, the lighter wire on negative. And on the back of the sub, we did the same thing. We got the dark on the positive,
and the silver on the negative. So we've got all that, and we've got our RCAs plugged in on the back of the amp. So the only thing to do now, well, not only thing, there's still plenty to do, and I'm doing this as short and sweet as I can. We've just got to get the blue remote wire and the RCA cables ran across the floor here, because we have carpet back there somewhere. There it is. There's my roll of carpet. And we're going to lay carpet out so that we can kind of keep all this, you know, dirt like this on the floor off. That way I just pull the carpet out, shake it, and be done with it. So we're going to, I'm going to cut out a nice piece of carpet that goes up to that corner there, the chair, and then across. Well, actually, I'll have it go all the way up, but I'll have another piece that's going to come across this way for the two pieces and just split it where the shifter is. So there you go. We have our carpet in. So the carpet's nice. It's, man, it's blending real well on the cart on the camera, but there's a line there. And I made a piece for there and made a piece for here. And it makes it easy to just kind of pull out, shake it out, get all the dirt out and put them back in. And same thing for here, right up to the bed. Nothing special, just makes it easier to keep the truck clean. So I used some Allen keys because I don't have the actual lock to put into the four holes to unlock it. And then you have to unscrew your air valves off the knobs. And then we're just gonna use an Allen key and get these right here out. So we've got this one here that I'm working on, 2, 3, and 4, and then we should have all that out. Let's get to it. Okay, so we got our first screws out. We got the bracket off, or beauty ring. And we've got 4 Allen keys, 1 in each hole of the stock semi-truck radio. And there it is, comes right out. So we'll pull these out. You can see how the lock works here on the side. So, and boom, there we go. There it is. All right, let's take a look at. All right, so we got the camera sitting up there. We're gonna unplug the antenna. That looks like this just gets squeezed in. There we go, we've got that off. Now, what I'd like to do is, because this is such a weird radio, if you remember seeing it in the video when I first got it, showed up at the house, I was like, oh man, this is so crazy looking, but I bet it's no different than any other radio I've put in. I just kind of want to give it a little test fit and see how it looks here. Oh, that's great. Look at that. That's going to work out real nice. I didn't push it all the way in, but it will lock. Man, that's awesome. And we'll see with the radio, with all the road noise and everything. We'll see if it helps and kind of brings out and makes the sound a little more fuller. So let's get on it. We're almost there. Trigger wire, RCAs. Bring those up and get these speaker wires in, and we're gonna have that done. Just like, this was a lot of fun. So we've got it plugged in, everything is hooked up, and I'm about to give you guys a sample of what it sounds like. Holy cow. So I might end up having to edit that, so I'll do 2 versions of this, but just in case, man, I really wish I had a thumb drive with me. I really wish I had a thumb drive with me, because I'm probably going to have to edit out what was just playing on the regular radio, because I don't want to get, you know, tagged for it, or demonetized, or whatever they call it and do on the radio. So I was hoping to have a little something, just give like a 5-second thing, but out there it sounds terrible.
Yeah.
In here it sounds pretty good. That's crazy. So
yeah, if you had a thicker carpet, it would lay down. You're gonna leave them wires hanging up by your feet?
No, no, no. I'm gonna tuck that underneath there and then put the carpet back on top so that it's there. I was just finishing up my video here, so.
I interrupted you?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's my boss guy, so. Thanks for watching. I got bonus footage for you coming next. Be sure to watch for that, but we've got it installed. We've put some bumps in the car, and it sounds really good. Hopefully they don't demonetize it for that. It's just a sample of what's going on with the sub in the truck and my semi-truck. And I think this is a really good video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. You know, stay kind to one another. I'm going to get a t-shirt that says free hugs on it. You can see I got my Street Speeds shirt on. Shout out to him, which is my inspiration for doing this. I've been watching Street Speed for probably 3-4 years, something like that. But this is great. I'm gonna clean up my bunk area, get my truck back in order and stuff like that. Here's your bonus footage, guys. So have a great day. All right, so since we're done with the semi-truck, here's your bonus footage. Ready? Here you go. Here you go. My boss found a much better IROC for me to do the project on, an LS swap. I got it up on a stand right now because I was gonna take you underneath and show you the bottom and everything, just like I did on the other Camaro. This motor is blown. We do have some brake lines that we're gonna have to replace, but this thing, I know it doesn't, it's probably not so flattering with all the clear coat peeling on it and stuff, but there's a lot of good qualities about this here Camaro. We've got electric trunk pop on it, third brake light. The dashboard is ruined, but we've got so much, everything else is so clean on this. We've got good carpet, everything, seats. Everything is so much better on this. So we just need a dash pad. We're gonna have to put some pins on the doors. But this car is way better. It's got an SLP loudmouth exhaust that somebody stuck on it. But there's, look at the doors. Nothing is rusted, and this is why I have the car jacked up. I want you guys to see what we got going on underneath here. This car is clean. Oh, hold on. Here we go. Look at the floors. These floors are way, way better. This is something that I look for. This little bend down, this trim right here, or not trim, but this piece, that's where you're supposed to put your scissor jack on. That's something that I look for. And look, it's not bent or folded over anywhere on the car. I mean, this is clean. The subframe is way better than the other one. I mean, we're gonna pressure wash and clean all this off. But I mean, you guys can see just from looking at it, this is way, way better. But look at that big 2.5, that's probably 2.75 exhaust. That's that SLP pipe all the way back. Look at that driver floor. All the way back, clean, no hole. There's the transmission leak. But this does have a blown, it's a blown 305. But you guys see how much way more better that this car is than the last one. Look at that. Actual metal, not fiberglass and cardboard. So there's your bonus footage. We got a way better Z28 that we're gonna LS swap. This is going to be a little bit bigger because this we're going to do a 6.0 liter in this with a 4L80E transmission and a couple other upgrades. Cam, hopefully just a cam, maybe some valve springs. My boss is weird though, so hope you enjoyed this bonus footage. Be safe out there. We'll see you soon. Bye.